So we're going to talk about how to set up the Swan-Ganz catheter, okay, or PA catheter. So if you were ever to receive a patient with a Swan that had not been already set up, it's pretty easy, but confusing if you've never done it before. So you've got your balloon port with your syringe attached to that. That's fine. Then we've got your PA and your CVP. Those both need to be hooked up to pressure tubings, right? You've got your infusion port. That needs to be hooked up to IV fluids, your temperature probe, and then some of the Swans, especially the open hearts, have the SVO2 module as well that needs to be plugged into that other brown cord and connected to the vigilance monitor. Okay, so this is the equipment you're going to need. I'm not going to open this, but this is nice to have your manifold for your tubings. This is your cardiac output setup. And then there's a type of pressure tubing in the supply room that has two, it's a bifurcated pressure tubing, okay? Then of course you need the pressure bag and your bag of saline. So you would set up your pressure tubing just like you would any other. So I know you guys don't need me to show you that. So we would prime this, right? And then you're gonna connect one to your CVP. And you're gonna connect one to your PA. It doesn't matter which one's which, because we're gonna figure that out in a little bit. Okay, so the other thing you need are your cords, and so there's going to be two red pressure cables. You're going to need a splitter, especially if the patient already has an A-line, which most of the patients do, right? And then you need your brown cord that has your temperature setups for your cardiac output, okay? So when you plug in your pressure cables, you're going to have to put in the splitter and then plug in one, two, three. So you'll see on the monitor when we plug in, we got a red for your A line, a yellow for your PA, a blue for your CVP. Now, this is maybe the only tricky part. You got to figure out which one's which. A-line will already be plugged in, right? Mm-hmm. That's separate from this. So what you can do is, we have this side connected to our PA. So plug one in. Oh, I can see right away, that's our CVP, right? So let's unplug that and put that into our CVP port. Okay, so now we got our CVP there. Then our other cord's gonna be, should be, our A-line, our PA catheter, okay? So then that's really it. This has been flushed. Now we've connected everything. Now all we have to do is zero these and we'll get our tracings, okay? Now, any questions about that part? Pretty straightforward, right? Okay, now, setting up our cardiac output. The kit comes in several pieces, okay? You have to get your bag of saline. You get your tubing and you spike it. It looks like this. You gotta connect your syringe. It only connects to one side, okay? And then just make sure all these connections are good and tight. Now this is sort of like a, like a pump, right? You gotta pull all the air through and get all the air out of this. So far, so good. This comes in the kit as well with the setup for the, cardiac output. You're gonna connect this to your three-way stopcock. And now, this goes on always on the CVP port, okay? You don't ever put your cardiac output on your PA port, because then you would be bolusing into the PA artery. You don't want to bolus anything in the pulmonary artery because you can rupture the artery. So this is just going to connect onto here. You're probably going to have to bend this over so you don't let the blood back up. But it only goes one way again, right? Male to female on this side. And then male to female on this side. So there you go. And then we have that part. Okay,
to get your CVP tracing, you need to have your stopcock open so that it's going toward the transducer, right? So now we're off toward the cardiac output. There's one more piece we need, which is the cord. Thank you.
So the brown part plugs into the brown. This is your temperature probe. And then you got two ends to this. One side goes into your PA catheter here. And be careful because you can bend the prongs that are inside there. But there's a notch in the cord, and there's a notch inside of the, and an arrow and a notch inside of the temperature port on the PA catheter. So just line those up, stick it in. It should go in nice and easy, and then you screw that on to hold it in place, okay? So that's where you're getting your core temperature. And then this is the temperature probe for the saline as it goes in when you're doing your, and this just slides in. So you just stick it in there like that. That's it. Now everything should be set up. Now, again, you got your A line, you got your CVP and your PA catheter, and you got your cardiac output. So this is where you should be able to go here. Sometimes you might need to go to the BT limits because it'll default to Celsius, and you probably don't want it in Celsius. It's easier to have it in Fahrenheit, right, for your own purposes. And that's really all there is to that. It's nice to have the manifold because then you can put your CVP, your PA, and then your A-line tubing, and it's nice and organized and not laying all over the place. Questions?
Where is, if they need to like immersion with you, like a bedside PA, where do we find it?
The PA catheters themselves, yeah. You mean? Yeah. So they're in the supply room on that metal rack. Should be.
They should be, okay.
Yeah, we can go and look, make sure that they're there. But with a PA catheter, remember that you're gonna start with an introducer sheath or cordless, right? So you gotta find that. That's a central line that needs to be put in, and then they would thread the swan in once you get the cordless. Yeah, so. If they've already got a central line, sometimes they use the guide wire and exchange it out for a cordless, or they put in a new line. So that's going to be step number one, is getting your introducer sheath put in. Mm-hmm.
Can you show us how wedge?
To wedge, okay. It's a little tricky to show you on this because it's not set up on a real patient. But if you go over to your monitor, up to the PA part, you can click on that. And then there's a screen here that says PA insert wedge. Of course, it's saying the waveform must be zeroed first, and we don't have a waveform. So normally you'd be able to click that and you're gonna get a big waveform on the screen there. And then on your syringe, you're gonna have to add, of course, some air here. And you don't have to worry about closing and opening this because this just has air in it, right? So, okay, so put your syringe on there. It's full of air. It doesn't pull back more than 1.5 cc's. That's the way the syringe is designed. And then you gotta make sure that this arrow is lined up. Your PA catheters might be slightly different because this is an older model, but it's the same idea. You got to make sure that this is lined up so that the air will go in. Otherwise, if it's not, it's not going to go in. Okay. And then you just slowly inflate that balloon. And then on your monitor, you should see a change in your waveform. Mm-hmm. Once that the waveform on the monitor goes from like this big waveform to a small little waveform, that's your wedge. Okay. So once you get that, you would stop inflating. You don't have to put the whole 1.5 cc's of air in there. And then it should give you a number right here, okay? And of course, we don't do wedge on like the open heart patients. We only do it with ICU patients when the doctor's requesting it. Other questions?
How do we, how do we count the placement of the
How do we count where the placement is? Okay, so pretend it's in the pillow here, right? So at the very end here, the big hash marks are 50 each. So this is 100. The big hash mark is 50. The little ones are 10 each. So this is 90. This is 80. This is 70. This is 60. And so let's say it's inserted here. It's a little less than 60, so we usually just kind of guess, like, oh, that's probably about 58, 57 centimeters, okay? Anything else?
Removal
of the swan?
Yeah.
Ah, that's easy. Okay, that's my favorite part because it's so nice and clean when you get done. What I usually like to do is take everything off. So first of all, we're taking it out anyway, so remove everything. Take this off. If there's a stopcock, you can turn the stopcock. If there's not, you can take this off and put a little 10cc syringe on the end of this. Take this off. I would probably do it like this. Okay. So I get it to where I have nothing but a swan hanging here, right? With all the ports closed. Because then it's nice and easy. You don't have to worry. Once you pulled it out, you got this bloody thing hanging, and then you got to try to detangle everything. It's a pain. So once you got everything detangled, the swan, the introducer, most of them have a locking mechanism on them so that you don't, it's not easy to pull it in and out accidentally. Mm-hmm. So you've got to twist that off of the cordis. Then you're going to, you can do this in the chair. You can do it in the bed. Okay. You're going to have the patient take a deep breath and hold it. And then you're going to watch on the monitor for any PVCs because this can cause like ventricular arrhythmias. And sometimes it could even, it could theoretically send the patient to the VTAC. I've never had that happen, but it could. So we're watching, so we say, okay, ready, one, two, three, take a deep breath and hold it. And then you're just slowly withdrawing it and you're watching the monitor for arrhythmias. And then that's it. And then you gotta detangle all the cords and get everything put back together. It's very satisfying, I think. Once you get everything cleaned up, it's like, oh, it looks like a normal.
And it should seal from the...
It self-seals. There's nothing that you need to do to the introducer sheath to get it to seal. It's not gonna let air in. It's not gonna let blood back out. It self-seals, yes. Other questions? Okay.